All right, guys, I'm chipping away at all your questions on the YouTube channel and Facebook. And this next video is based on a kind of a comment, not a question. It's basically a disagreement. Someone said, "Dr. Berg, you don't know what you're talking about because our bodies were meant to run on glucose, especially the brain." And I wanted to do a video on this topic because I think it's important. It is true that a certain part of your body can only run on glucose, okay? But a greater portion of your body can also run on ketones and fatty acids. I mean, if you just think about this logically, most people in America especially are overweight. They're carrying a lot of fat around their body. Now, the question is, what is the purpose of fat? Is it just an insulator? Is it just to protect you against the cold or act as a cushion if you fall down? Or could it be that that fat that you have is a fuel storage to survive between meals? Our bodies only store roughly about 1700 calories of stored sugar, but a thin person has about 100,000 calories of stored fat. So, based on logics, our bodies were meant to run on fat more than glucose. But it is true that certain parts of our body only can live on glucose, and that would be the red blood cells. Your liver, your liver actually cannot run on ketones. 30% of your brain, especially certain parts of your pituitary and hypothalamus, need glucose. Certain parts of the kidney can only run on glucose. And the lens of the eye needs glucose. But here's the key thing. There's something called gluconeogenesis. That is a condition where your body is actually making glucose from non-carbohydrate sources like fat and ketones. That's right. If your body needs glucose, it can make it from ketones. So you do not need from your diet any glucose to survive at all. In fact, when you start putting your body into a state of ketosis and you start feeding the brain ketones and your heart ketones, you see all sorts of amazing things that occur. Improvements in focus, memory, ability to learn, and your overall mood. And just because I'm on the topic of brain physiology, there's a structure in the brain called a hippocampus. And that structure, if damaged, leads to dementia and Alzheimer's. And your hippocampus thrives, it improves when you feed it ketones. And it worsens when you feed it glucose. So both the hippocampus and the prefrontal cortex thrives on ketones. And this is exactly why when you get into ketosis, your focus is better, your memory gets better, and your concentration improves. And so if you're new to my channel and this is all new to you, definitely watch some videos down below so you can experience the massive benefits.
Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US. Hopefully, in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.